recognize the pastor for just the wonderful job that they've all been doing. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you so much. And then all the mothers that are here, Mother McDaniel came by the house yesterday and brought Pastor Kate, he and I. And I said, Lord, you didn't know she was 97. Cannot say thank you enough. Amen. To God be the glory for the wonderful things He has done. Amen. I'm looking at that and I begin to think about Jehoshaphat. And I thought about Sister Miranda. You can be in a fight, what you think?
Well,
and God will step in. Set them enemies against each other. Instead of them coming together to fight you, He confused you. And they killed each other.
Yeah.
You know what the devil meant for bad? God turned it around to your good. You can win that, and then you can get your hands dirty. Because I think sometimes we think we have to fight. We think we got to handle it. But all the handling in the world, it ain't handled until God handles it. It's not. I've been mad and I said this and I did that. After all that, you shit still ain't over. You went home on weekend thinking that's done. You went back and all this money, they said, we're going to talk to you again. Because it ain't done until God says it's done. And in this way, God began to minister to me with that. You ain't got to fight. He said, that battle's not even yours to fight. So if it ain't yours to fight, it sure ain't yours to win. So you can fight it, but you're going to lose it. But if we let Him fight, every time we win. When people walked away, they can't. They clothes weren't dirty, their hair was still intact. They had their earrings on, their tracks were still in place.
You ain't fancy, ain't fancy.
But You gotta have your mind made up. You gotta have it. If you're gonna serve the Lord, you're gonna have some hard times and some good times. Hello, somebody. You're gonna have good days and you're gonna have bad days. You're gonna cry some, you're gonna shout some. Hello, somebody. I got news for you. On the days you cry don't mean you no savior than on the days when you were shouting. Know who you are in Christ. Hello, somebody. My mind went to Joseph in the Bible. He had a no matter what attitude. Can I tell you, his mind was made up. Even though his brothers didn't like him, they was jealous of him. Hello, somebody. Even though his dad liked him the best, Jacob made him a coat of many colors. Clearly called him the favorite. Guess what? He still had to go through something. Brothers and all, we're going to get rid of you. You want to make a way. You better than him than all the rest of us. We get rid of you, we got a chance. They wanted to kill him. Put him in the pit. Later sold him into slavery. Now I want to go to one scripture. You all go with me, please. This is our thematic scripture. Genesis 39:2. And Genesis 39:2. And the Lord was with Joseph. And he was a prosperous man. And he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And I will go back right there. And the Lord was with Joseph. That's all that matters. Because if God be for you, he is more than the world against you. The Lord was with Joseph. He went to the pit. Then he got there, and guess what? Potiphar, he found favor in Potiphar's eyes. Potiphar said, you know what? The Lord was with him, and the Lord's favor was upon him. And Potiphar knew something was different about him. He said, guess what? I'm going to bring you into the house, and you will be close to me. Potiphar took a liking to Joseph. But the sad part was, Potiphar's wife took a liking to Joseph as well, which caused some trouble for Joseph. Hello, somebody. So then she lied on him, trying to act like he did something he wasn't supposed to do, which landed him in jail. But that was all a part of God's plan. Hello, somebody. Because if he never went to jail, he never would have met the baker nor the butler. But since he went to jail, he had an opportunity to interpret their dreams. Hello, somebody. Here we got. He was in the pit. Now he in jail. But wait a minute. Let's look at that verse again. What does that verse say? 39:2. Let's read that first portion. And the Lord, he in prison. God was with him. And I think sometimes where people are in life, sometimes it looks like God ain't with them. But Joseph was right there. But God was still with him. He was able to interpret the dreams of the butler and the baker. The Lord blessed one to get out, one died, and says the dream said he was able to interpret things and get it all straight for him. And then here comes Pharaoh, needing to find out about his dream. He called for the soothsayers and the magicians, and nobody could interpret the dream. But there's Joseph in prison. Hello, somebody. They said, we're going to go to the prison. Open the gate. We need you, brother. And that's God making a way. Come out of there. Was able to interpret the dream, and things were able to turn around the 7 years of peace, 7 years of famine, and God made a way. He ended up being second in command. And then he ended up standing over his brothers, who didn't quite know that that was their brother. But that's the way God would do it. So he could clown with them. I don't know, y'all. Y'all ain't getting nothing up in here. Hello, somebody. But guess what? God was in him. God was working in him. And he had a no matter what attitude. What? No matter who's against me, no matter who's for me, no matter who's trying to kill me, no matter who don't like me, no matter who lie on me, guess what? I love the Lord and I won't take it back. For God I live and for God I die. So you can block me so you think, but you'll never stop me. Because what God has to do, he wants to do it through me. Guess what? And you can't block God's vision. Get in the way if you want to, God will move you out the way. Gave up. Somebody would have made it to the house and thought they had it made. Then when they dropped back down in the prison, would have quit. But Joseph was like, oh no, I ain't quitting. I got a feeling everything gonna be all right up in here. Famous one, Job. Job had a no matter what attitude, didn't he? He was a bad boy. You know, I like Job because I think we, you know, everybody, we cool with folks when they got it going on. By the time they look like they ain't got it going on, the folks don't want to be bothered with you. As long as you're pulling up in your, whatever you try, you know, when you pulling up in your clunker, so I get a ride, go home. Go on, I'll find a way. Hello, somebody. Y'all know what I'm talking about. They rolling in the big Mercedes. You like, hey, come on. You come out looking good, too. You know what I mean? But when things go south, how do people act? Richard Aaron Bell said sometimes. Job, he was a very wealthy man. He had a large family, extensive flock. He was blameless and upright. But one day everything changed. He lost his livestock, lost his servants, and lost his children. And somebody would have lost their mind. You go from having all that to not having all that, it's going to take God to sustain you. He had 10 children. They died. He lost all of that. But guess what? He had a no matter what attitude. See, the devil was talking to the Lord. And he was like, hey, I want to deal with him. So I said, hey, you consider my servant Job? And he's like, oh yeah, I'll take him. Well, he said, but God, you got fence around.
Right.
Remove the fence and I'll deal with it. So he snatched all that stuff away from him. And Job was still like, Lord, I love you. I love you. So the devil rolled back in on God and said, you know what, God? You let me touch all that stuff around him. Let me touch him. Let me touch his body. God said, okay, just don't touch his legs. Went back out with boils on his body. Man, as sick as you don't know what. His friends come over. You know how friends do. They try to figure it out for you. You don't figure it out for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Daddy, this what's wrong? What you even done? You must have really done something. Job was perfect and upright. He had done nothing. The friends rolling in trying to bring you more gloom and doom. If it ain't bad enough, you know, bro, I ain't never seen nobody. When you sitting high and things as well, you got diamonds and murderers and me. You happy with all that get going, you be like, you know what? I knew I should have married you. Things have not been going the way you want. Things have been going. Get I'm determined that I won't let Facebook consume all of my day. Come on, somebody. I'm determined that I won't let that person, girl or boy, who's not my spouse, consume all of my day. God gave me this day. And I'm not going down that road anymore. I'm not going down. And I gotta say this, it's not our own mind.
That's right.
Told one of our children recently, if you hear the mind telling you to do something good, that's God. For somebody. He's not going to talk to you like that. That's God speaking to you. Speaking to you. Saying forgive. Love. Give it up. All of that by knowing the word of God will help us to take on a no matter what attitude. And today, I want to afraid. Come on down and give your life to Jesus. If you're ready for an eternity.